Lex out. That was a good one.
Let's go.
Yeah, that was probably my furthest one of the day.
Come out.
I don't know. That's definitely going to be 550 plus, but did he get to 600 with that?
What up, Huck Squad? In today's video, I am doing a form comparison between myself and Dylan Cappuccioli. Dylan can consistently throw over 500 feet and even over 550 feet when he really connects on a throw. And I can consistently throw over 400, maybe over 425, 450 if I really connect on a throw myself. And in today's video, I'm going to be breaking down some key differences between his backhand throw and my backhand throw. I'm not like the best person at dissecting a throw. There are probably some things that I miss here between weight transfer and maybe some other things. I really am not the best at looking at a throw and kind of seeing what to do differently, but I did see some clear-cut differences here. And just as a little bit of a disclaimer, I'm not upset about being able to throw over 400 feet and up to 450 on a good rip. That is really some solid distance, and I know a lot of people might be striving to even get to the 400 feet mark. So if you are under 400, under 300, keep working at it, and I still hope that some of these tips are able to help you out. Some people just are never gonna be able to throw over 500, 550, 600 feet, and that is okay. But as long as you take some of these away and do your best to work on it, I'm sure that you'll be able to optimize the amount of distance that you can get out of your arm speed and out of the amount of spin that you can put onto a disc. We will start with a full speed side-by-side comparison. We'll check this out a couple times and then we'll go into the slow-mo to break it down. And you can see just by the flight of the disc that Dylan's is turning kind of as mine is coming out. And we'll take another look at that, full speed. I'm releasing a little bit more flat, whereas Dylan is actually releasing on hyzer, but the amount of torque that he's putting into it is turning it over. Whereas if you look at my throw, I'm kind of trying to like force it over, whereas Dylan's is a lot more comfortable of just like a power drive. So we'll go into the slow motion now. There's a couple different tips that I really want to talk about. The first is going to be wrist position and core position. So if you kind of look here, my wrist is kind of cocked over the top of the disc and more at like a downward angle right there, whereas Dylan's is more on the front of the disc and more at like a horizontal angle. Even his disc is kind of like on a hyzer angle, whereas mine isn't really on necessarily any sort of angle. It's more flat at this point. Another thing that you can notice is he is standing pretty much straight up and down. Dylan and I have very similar statures. We're both, you know, 6'4". I think I might have like an inch of height on him. He probably has a couple pounds on me, but we're very similar stature. So I should be able to utilize my length a little bit better than I do. And after watching kind of how he uses his length and his body, it definitely opened my eyes to things that I can work on the next time that I go to the field. You can see I'm kind of like hunched over. Like there's kind of like an angle here between my plant leg and my upper body. Whereas Dylan, he's about to start reaching back and he's still standing straight up and down. So wrist position kind of cocked on the top and I'm kind of like hunched over. Dylan's more straight and has his wrist kind of in front of the disc, a little bit more parallel and horizontal. You can see when Dylan gets to the point of being fully reached back, he's already, look at that, he's got a perfectly straight arm and his disc is behind his center of gravity. I'm not even at a point right now where I'm at my full reach back, but you can already see not only am I still like really hunched over, I'm also like reaching kind of out in front of my body, not behind my center of gravity. So already I can notice that I need to stand up a little bit straighter and then reach back a little bit straighter and behind my body rather than out. And these aren't things like I said, I've been playing for almost a decade or a little bit over a decade. And now my throw is just so subconscious that I don't really think about these sort of things. But while I was writing notes for this comparison, I was like, holy crap, there really is a lot that I can work on. You can see that his left shoulder and left hip are really open. My left hip isn't completely open and my left shoulder definitely isn't as open as his. I'm still hardly at full reach back right here. Let's see if we can get to the exact moment that I'm at full reach back, it might be kind of tricky. So it's kind of like right there, but you can't even really tell because my arm isn't straight. It's still at a right angle, or not a right angle, but it's definitely at an angle. And Dylan's fully braced for his throw, fully reached back, directly behind his center of gravity. And it even looks like I'm trying a lot harder. Like, it looks like I'm putting a lot more into this, whereas Dylan looks really relaxed. If you kind of watch his body language throughout the throw, he looks really relaxed and he doesn't really look like he's stressing it that much. But if you watch me, like my face, I kind of have the Huck face going the whole time. And right here, you can even see like vein, like I'm really trying really hard to throw that disc and I'm not really having the smoothest form. So you can kind of see that I'm not having the same results as someone that does have really smooth form. So there's a couple really key differences that we've already touched on so far. And I know we mentioned it when we were looking at the full speed version, but just look at how I release the disc. I'm already releasing flat and Dylan is releasing on a hyzer, but the amount of power, torque, and spin he's putting into that is going to turn it over, whereas I'm kind of trying to like force it to turn because I'm not putting as much power into it. We'll watch this slow motion for full, from the start, and there's just so much that you can learn from those two throws and those two flights. There are some similarities. Like, something I noticed was we both took our eyes off the target at pretty much the same time, which was around right here, and we're both kind of starting our reach back, but he's very quick to get it into the loaded position. So he gets loaded and he continues to load his lower body forward, whereas I'm not really getting into a loaded position. I'm really just, my throw is really like one fluid circular motion, whereas Dylan's is straight back and straight forward. And he's really loaded throughout this throw. Like, he's at full reach back for a good amount of time. But if you look over here on the left at me, I just kind of, I don't even stop for a moment. It's kind of like a circular fluid motion. There's no stop in that. So Dylan's kind of, he pauses right there and he loads into the throw. So that's a good, like, I don't even know how many different tips that is, but that's probably 8 to 9 to 10 different tips that you can pull away from this. And there's so much to be learned. And next time I go out to the field, I'm literally gonna rewatch this video or just look at these notes that I made. I just want you guys to know that Dylan throwing 550 feet is not an accident. And watching this video really proved that to me. He's doing everything right when it comes to form and timing. And he's definitely come a long way as a player in the past, even like 2 to 3 years, really polishing his game. And he's nowhere near his skill ceiling right now. So just a big kudos to Dylan and all the success that he's seen over the past couple years and how much he's grown as a player. It's really been cool to see. Hope you guys enjoyed this little form comparison video. I will go back. We can watch the full speed. We'll watch the slow-mo. And then you can get a couple more of Dylan's shots. If you want to see this whole video, go check out the DD3 comparison. It's a couple videos back. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Take it easy.
Five sixty-six. It's like my furthest driver.
578. Yeah, you beat it by 2 feet. No.
598.
So close.
598 again.
Pinged 598 twice. Oh man.
Rip.
Good rip though. Good stuff, dude.